Alright, HadesOmega here, and today I have my 1991 Toyota Previa. I'm doing a video about. So I always want to do a video on like all my cars, because I guess my Z video is pretty popular. But so this is what I ride around for like when I want to move stuff. The main reason I bought this van was so I could do deliveries with it. I used to be a delivery driver and I used to deliver packages. So I used to have an 86 Toyota van. I miss it a whole lot. I actually like driving that one better than this one. But this one has it comes standard with cruise control and air conditioning, which my 86 Toyota van did not have. But I use this mainly for moving stuff around now. I'm not a delivery driver, but this van was totally up to the task. I've had this van like totally full of packages and stuff, delivering them, and it did the job pretty well. It's got decent hauling power, even though it's only a 2.4 liter engine. These vans are like, the special thing, there's tons of Previas on the road, but the special thing about this Previa, it's my Previa, is that it's a 5-speed manual. You don't see a lot of manual minivans. My Toyota van was a manual also, but get that out. The stick shift on this van, I don't like it at all. it's kind of like they didn't put much thought into it. The stick shift on my 86 van was much better than my this Previa. I don't like this. It's like the linkage isn't very nice. This has these little plastic spacers on it that go where the ball joints are. And they pop off sometimes. It's kind of weird. It's really weird, but I mean, and it's a pain in the ass to get it back on. And it doesn't shift very good. And then you have to like kind of reach down here for it. I actually have a shifter extension. It'll extend this up here, but then the throw is long, so you do have to do all these long throws. So, I mean, if I can find it, if they do make a short shifter kit for this, I would get it. I would get the short shifter kit, and or you'd probably have to make one. That's another thing. But if I can get if I can shorten the throw on this and then increase the height, it'll be perfect. I like it shifting like right here. This is where you naturally would grab the shifter. But I just keep the stock one. This is actually not the stock shifter. Also, it's I think it's from a Toyota Tercel, that's why it only has 4 gears on it. But I like the ball shifter better. So let me go talk about this van a little bit. Right now it's at 229,000 miles. So these vans have been known to be very dependable. And a special characteristic about these Toyota Previa vans, they don't make them like this anymore, but it's a mid-engine rear-wheel drive, so basically you're sitting on top of the engine. If you were to take the seat out, or you could actually flip it back. I'm not gonna flip it back all the way, but see how the seat moves back like that. There's actually an engine access panel right here that you can use to put oil or check oil. So basically the engine is right here where you're sitting on top of the engine, and it's a rear wheel drive. Like most minivans nowadays are front wheel drive, and it has a solid rear axle, so it's very the components are very much like a truck. So it was designed for like heavy duty use, so that's an interesting characteristic. It's a mid-engine. Like, you don't see a lot of mid-engine. Well, there kind of are. My Toyota van was one, but that means like the engine sits between the front and the rear axles. But it's not like a Toyota MR2. If it was an MR2, the engine would be like right here, like right in front of the rear axle, but this one is right behind the front axle. So it actually does qualify, like it does qualify to be a mid-engine. And I always joke like, hey, yeah, my van is it's mid-engine, like a Ferrari, because most Ferraris are mid-engine. Because it's the good thing about mid-engine cars is that they have like a better they have like an ideal that ideal weight balance. But you know, it's a minivan. But I do hear that Previas have very good traction because of where the engine is. They're good to drive, like, and better to drive in the snow, even than the Toyota van. And they do make these in all-wheel drive, but this is the rear-wheel drive version. So that's you know, those are the basics. It's let me show you the. There's actually a hood, even though the engine is here. This is the hood. And what basically the engine is way back there. There's actually, you can see back there, there's a drive shaft that goes from the front of the engine's crankshaft to this, to over here where all the accessories are. So Toyota designed it, you know. Okay, it's kind of a bad, it's a good design and a bad design at the same time, because you have this extra drive shaft that needs attention, and the bushings on mine are kind of wearing out. But yeah, you can access all the stuff, like the maintenance stuff, from the hood. You don't have to get to the engine like a normal car. So I mean, you put your coolant here. This is coolant reservoir tank. This actually has a coolant. It has an engine oil reservoir. So what this does is when the oil level gets low, it senses it's low, it'll actually pump some oil into the engine. Most people don't use it. You know how you can just fill it up through the engine like a normal car. And the washer fluid's here. And there's like, they got all the space here. I use this extra space to put like an air pump here and my hitch ball mount there. The radiator is under here. This has got a battery. The air intake is here. And that's one of the modifications I did. It's like a open air filter, and the power steering fluid, and the brake and clutch reservoir right here. So they made the maintenance very simple on this. The maintenance, it doesn't really need a whole lot of maintenance. It's just one of those that you just kind of drive it, and you make sure you change the oil every once in a while. And the oil change intervals are like 5,000 miles on these. And this thing takes up a lot of oil. And an interesting thing to note about a Previa is it has a wet sump, or it constantly has oil pumped through the engine because of the way the engine is mounted. They actually mounted the engine almost sideways, just to get it to fit under there. So yeah. It's a very cool van, and they're known to be very reliable. Like I've seen Previas in the junkyard with more than 200,000 miles. I even saw one with 300,000 miles one time. So this one is 230. It's still, you know, still got some ways to go. This particular model is a DX model. It's the base model, so it doesn't really come with a lot of extra options. But I've added a lot of extra options to it. So yeah, so let me just get to my customizations. So my first mod, you can see, is I got this kind of open element air filter. And yeah, it takes up a lot of this space. It gets dirty quick though. And then I have these LED lights. The lights on the Previa aren't very good, at least in the earlier models, because they don't have the H4 lights. But I add these LEDs. They're gonna be yellow now though. I just polished the headlights yesterday though, so. Oh yeah, I also wanted to add, I have clear corner lights. the stock lights have a, yeah, it's not really much of a difference, you know, and I had to pay to get these special ones. But yeah, this one is completely clear. The reflector on the stock lights is an amber. So, but I think it looks great with the clear lights. See how everything is nice and clear on the front? And also, this is the 91. They made two versions. They made a late model version. Well, okay, I guess you can count the 95 and up had superchargers, but this one doesn't have the supercharger. The Previa came in a lot of different models and came with a lot of different options. This is the earlier model, and the bumpers look a little different on this guy. The front bumper mostly. But yeah, it has power windows, power locks. Pretty cool. These ones, the side windows, they push out, and it's got AC and cruise control. It doesn't, the only thing it doesn't have over the LE version is, at least for features, is it, well, it doesn't have the disc brakes in the back, and this is what the front looks like. That's what it looks like out of there. This thing has a huge windshield. That's what it looks like when you're driving it. It feels like you're really high up. But yeah, also it doesn't have a variable windshield wiper control, which I wish, I was wondering if I can swap that out from a newer Previa. Oh yeah, I got racing pedals. It makes it easier to heel and toe. Because yes, I do drive this van hard. And now I got some good tires on it, so. Oh, actually, that center console there, see what all that junk in it? Actually has, is actually from a different, a later model Previa too. So, that normally wasn't there, but I added it. And it kind of just sits there too. And another thing about the Previa is it has these, oh yeah, to change the spark plugs, you gotta take the seat out. It's a real pain in the ass, so you don't do it very often. That's why you buy really good plugs. But this has a huge glove box. Look at how much junk you can fit in there. So I've never seen a car with a glove box this big. I mean, still put a little more stuff in there. It's amazing how much stuff you can fit inside a Previa. There's these ones on the door. I think in the newer Previas, there's a speaker here. The speakers are actually under here. And yeah, the fuses are under here. It's a... And what else? The bumpers. Normally, the Previa comes with unpainted gray plastic bumpers. Very tough bumpers, and you can see like, these have been plasti dipped. I plasti dipped all the bumpers. I think that, well, after a while, the plastics start to fade and they look yucky. So, and I moved the plate to the side, and I have an angled plate. Kind of cool, but it's whenever you hit anything, it fucks the plate up, so sucks. So the bumpers have been plasti dipped. In my opinion, it looks much better plasti dipped black. I like it. And the back gets all chewed up because I use this to load heavy objects in, so I just slide it in through the bumper. So I don't bother touching that up. I probably did need to touch up the front, but the plasti dip holds up really well. It's a great bumper paint. This one just looks like it needs to be touched up a little bit. It makes the van look cool. And I'm kind of going for that blue and black paint scheme. It's got a bra. In my opinion, the Previa needs it, because for some reason it gets a lot of rock chips. And I think this one has a lot of rock chips too, that's why it has the problem. But I actually bought this off of my uncle. And what else? We got, these are the wheels from my Mitsubishi Eclipse. These are from 2GB, the Koki or the late version Eclipse from a Spider, but you can get them on a GS also or a GST. So I like these wheels. I don't have them on my Eclipse anymore, and I thought I'd put them on here, and they look good. They're 16-inch wheels, and they're wrapped in some Falcons. And then my last performance mod is it's got a custom muffler. Now the Previa is a horrible van to put a performance muffler on because it's very loud. Like I've had to experiment with this muffler like so much, and actually my catalytic converter got stolen on it one time too. So it was I've had quite an adventure with this muffler. But let me take a look at it. There it is. So what it is it's a Mugen style muffler. So what it is, it has the hole coming in the back. And it goes through the muffler and it loops once around and it goes back into the muffler and out. So that way it acts as if it has a longer piping. And what that does is it quiets it down and it gives it better torque response. So and you can see that this is a solid rear axle. Oh, actually, and speaking of the axle, this has the it has a differential from I just swapped the gears over. From a supercharged Toyota Previa, it has a wider gear set. So this thing will cruise better on the freeway now. So, but I lose torque from it. But the van still has plenty of power. And I put some lower profile tires, so it kinda evens out. But I like it, I don't like it to, it's usually used to scream on the freeway a lot. But yeah, there's the muffler. And it was still loud with that. So what I did is I added a resonator right here. This is actually from a Chrysler Sebring, I think, is where I got it. I found it in the junkyard. I got like the smallest inline muffler or resonator I could get, and that helped quiet it down quite a bit. You see, another interesting to note is that the Previa has a factory headers. Look at those. It's not an exhaust manifold, they're actual headers. They're tuned headers. And look at that beautiful design there. The distributor is right on top of the exhaust. So, also these have a oil leaking problem too. Sometimes the gasket will leak and then the oil will leak onto the exhaust. I almost forgot to mention the Mugen muffler. I also modified it. It had a lip before, but I cut the lip off, and then I can install. I installed a 3-inch silencer on it, and I actually got a tunable silencer that like you can adjust how much it opens and stuff. So how much noise, but right now it's kind of noisy, but with the silencer in there, it's pretty quiet. I have another video, I think, with the silencer on there. But yeah, we can go fire it up real quick. Have a listen. Alright, let's fire this bad boy up. Oh, that's what the muffler sounds like. Sounding van now. Still a little noisy on the freeway. If I was gonna do a really long trip, I would probably put the silencer in. Then it almost sounds like stock. This is a DX model, not the LE model. It has drum brakes, so the rear is drum on these ones, which it's no big deal for me. Since this the brakes aren't very good on this van when I first got it, I guess the brake pads were kind of crappy or something, but I upgraded them with some drilled and slotted motors, and you can see them through the wheels, so they're pretty dope. And and it has some Metal Master semi-metallic pads, and yeah, they help the braking a lot. You know, Because when I'm hauling stuff, I need to have good brakes. And or when I'm I actually take this on mountain roads sometimes, because I like to go mountain biking. It's another thing I use this van for. And I just throw my bike inside the back, and then I just ride up the mountain. And yeah, this it's a great handling van. Handles I would say it handles a lot like a mid-engine car. My Toyota van handled more like a rear-wheel drive. It would want to slide all over the place like a rear-wheel drive, but this one doesn't really do that. It's got a ton of grip. It has a big front sway bar, so good times. But you can still do burnouts in it. And it actually has a spoiler. This was not here before. I added a spoiler from the LE model. That's another upgrade I've done. Just make it look cooler. And well, since we're on the topic of the body, I also have these window shades, or the rain shields. They've turned white after a while. These are copies of the Toyota version. So there's some fancy Toyota ones that they made. The Toyota, I think, has like a Toyota decal here, and it's all clear, I think. I did try to tint it with some tint paint, but I don't know, this isn't working very well. I might just paint it. It looks ugly now. but they help a lot. So you can see here, I can stick my hand in there, but you can't tell it's open. So you can keep the window open a crack to keep the van thing nice and cool. They also provide some shade. So I like it. It creates a big blind spot for you though. But I have these Previa mud guards. These ones in the rear. These are like custom mud guards for the Previa. They look freaking dope. And I had these imported from UK. As they said, they had these in for the UK Previas. They might have made them in the US, I don't know, but you can't get them anymore, I think. But, yeah, I had it imported from UK through eBay. Basically, I saw them on eBay. I've also installed a backup camera. Let's see here. So just turn it on. Let's see what's behind us, which is the ground. And it has these little actual these lines to so you can judge the distance. It's pretty cool. And it makes parking easy. So dusty. And it has I have a backup beeper too, installed in the reverse lights. People could hear. This van has an aftermarket hitch that I got at found at a van on at Pick and Pull. I think it's a Kirk hitch or something, but it's a class 2. It's modified with a custom 2-inch receiver. So there were some Previa models that did come with 2-inch receiver, and it was a bumper mounted one, like actually on the bumper. It was actually part of the bumper. This is just an add on. It hooks up where the tow hooks hook. But yeah, I use this van to tow my Harbor Freight trailer, so that's why I kind of need it. And it's also when I bought this van for my uncle, it already had some tint on it. It had tint on the sides. It has some kind of mirror tint, like a silverish mirror tint, so you can see me right here. Say hey. But yeah, it had kind of like a little light silvery window tint, and actually I added extra window tint to it. So it's super dark now, and I just had the back tinted. The back wasn't tinted. So one of the reasons you'd want to put tint on a Previa is because these windows are huge, and Previas have this greenhouse effect. I guess it's good in the winter, but yeah, the heat will come in, like the sun will beat in through the windows, and it'll get hot inside. And the air conditioning isn't so good on the Previa, at least mine anyway. And yeah, so that's the reason I got all tinted. But in California, we can't tint the front windows or the side windows. So this is the extent to what I can tint it. I actually left so annoying. I actually left that window. See that this window, this window and these two windows are have two layers of tint, so they're very dark. And I like them dark too because I camp with this van, and when I sleep inside the van, I don't like, you know, less light goes in, and you know, people can't see you sleeping in here or whatever. You get more privacy. And then like, yeah, I left this one open, so like if I'm gonna back out of a driveway or something, I can see through the window. You can still kind of see through that one. And I wanted the back as dark as possible because I have the backup camera. So yeah, that's what I do to keep the van cool. But of course it has AC, so if it's really hot outside, you can cool the inside down pretty good. So here's the inside. I've optimized it for cargo. There's no seats in here. Well, at least there's a seat right here. I'll show you how that works. But this used to be a bench seat configuration where you can put, there's a bench seat here that fits two, and then you can fold these seats down. There's supposed to be another one right here, but that one's the only one I retained. Because actually I put my quad in here also. My Yamaha Warrior fits in here. It's a pretty big quad, so it's not bad. You can fit a lot of stuff in here. It only has one sliding door. This is not before the era of dual sliding doors. But yeah, you can actually see there's a strap right there. You can take that down and then fold it. I got this cargo strap here to keep stuff from falling out too. And you put the headrest here. I'm not gonna do it, but it's an interesting thing to know about the Previa. You flip this out. And then there's actual, see these hooks here? That's where that'll latch onto. And then and you put it down, and then you put the backup. That's actually quite an ingenious solution to folding seats in the van. Most vans nowadays have stow-and-go seating, but like you have to have a really tall deck. This van is actually, all the weight is kept really down low, so I don't have any issues pushing it to its cornering limits, because is it really all the weight is down low, so that's what makes the handling so good. Like they don't make them like this anymore. That's a back shot. I actually have this is a backup camera, so I added one from Amazon. Pretty cool. It just has like a wire. It's a wired one unit, so it goes in here and it goes all the way to the front. You get some wiring over there. There's actually, I have a sub here. It's I think it's like an 8-inch sub or a 10-inch sub. It's a flat sub. It works good. I had to put a sub in because it's really loud on the freeway. So if I can turn my beats up high enough to overpower the exhaust, that'll be awesome. It came with a Sony deck stock. My uncle put it in, so. But yeah, all the wiring comes here. It looks kind of ghetto. But I actually have, speaking of electronics, I actually have some jumper packs. My van's kind of dirty right now, but I actually have, ta-da, an inverter right here connected straight to the battery through this cable here. It goes out here and out through a boot back there, connects straight to the battery. Actually, I actually have another, and it has extra 12-volt cigarette lighter receptacles. These ones are always on, and I have the one here. This one is only on when the accessory is on, so I got like, quite a few electronics upgrades done on this van. Also, these seats aren't these aren't the original seats in this Previa. These ones have armrests. This is from a LE, I think. Yeah, I like these. This is really nice. The armrest has adjustable armrests. That's basically the only difference. One thing I don't like about the Previa seats is that you sit so high up in it, and I mean, it's understandable. You're sitting on top of the engine. It feels like you're sitting really high, but the vehicle sits really low. And going back to the topic of seats, yeah, so you can fold those two down, and I think you can have three people in the back. It's kind of weird. It's a weird configuration, but three people can sit in the back, two people can sit in the middle row, And then one person up here. So you can carry a total of 6 passengers. Pretty good for a minivan. 7 with the driver. I heard there's another model where you can fit 8 people. So I don't know, but it's not a people carrier van. I don't use it as a people carrier van. Yep. So yeah, if you have another one, it would flip down and you would have the bench seat right here. And some models came with captain seats with, like, there'll be like a seat here, and it'll like pivot and stuff. Pretty cool. But yeah, I just use it for cargo. You can fit an enormous amount of stuff in here. Look at it. It's not as tall as my Toyota van, but it's wide. And I like how I like the design that Toyota made. The wheel wells, well, it's flat for one thing. It's very flat. The Toyota van, to make it flat, they had to use leaf springs. But this actually has coil springs, so they were able to make it nice and flat with the coil springs. On the Toyota van, the coil springs, like, they stick out of the floor. But yeah, it's pretty flat, and the wheel wells are small. It's it's amazing how Toyota was able to do that. So it's a great design on this van. And the engine is in a Toyota Previa is a 2.4 liter. 2.4 liter inline 4. It's like at almost 90 degrees. It's like 70 degrees or something. So like the engine is like sideways, basically. So that's why it has to have that special oil pump system and everything. And you would think it would get gas mileage with a 2.4 liter, right? It does not. It actually, on average, this van will get 19 miles per gallon. And maybe 22 if I'm not going very fast on the freeway. Yeah, so I think the best I've ever gotten is maybe like 22. Typically it gets 18 to 19 miles per gallon, which is horrible because it's a manual also. It should get better gas mileage if it's a manual. But yeah, like I said, the manual isn't really all that on this, but it does make it fun to drive. I'll tell you that. You feel more direct power response from the engine. And yeah, so it's pretty much all the mods I've done to it. And I really like this van. Yeah, the gas mileage really isn't that good. I used to have a Pontiac Transport with the V6, 3.8 liter, and boy did that have a lot of power. But and it got 18 miles per gallon, so I'm like, but you know what's awesome about these Previas is their reliability. This van is a 1991. It's over 20 years old now. Over 20 years old, and everything still works on this van. Everything. I used to have a Pontiac van, and all electronic stuff, it stopped working slowly. But everything still works on this van, amazingly. Yeah, the AC still works. Power steering works still good. It's got more than 200,000 miles. Transmission still shifts okay. You know? Everything still works on it. It's amazing for such an old van. And I look forward to, I have a good time with it. I use it as, a RV and a cargo vehicle. So what I'll do is I'll just sleep in it, and I tow with it also. I've towed refrigerators. Like, I've moved like a whole house with this van, so this van can move a serious amount of stuff. And then I have the trailer. I can even move even more stuff with that thing. So this thing is a workhorse, and it loves it. It's got more power than a Toyota van. Toyota did a very good job with this van. They didn't really catch on in America because everyone wanted all more powerful vans, like the Dodge Ram and stuff, Dodge Caravan. But this is definitely a unique van, and I think Toyota made this van, this model of the Previa, or it's called Estima in around the world. They made this version of the van like for America. They engineered it for Americans. They made it bigger, you know? And this is their answer. And I mean, it's very reliable. You don't have to worry about the oil or any of that stuff. Like it actually changes its own oil almost, you know. But you do 5,000 mile oil changes. Very, very low maintenance, man. There's no timing belt. I do have heard that if you blow the head gasket on this guy, so you want to make sure the cooling system is good on this. But yeah, with any high mileage vehicle, you know, you're gonna have problems with the head gasket. This one has had it changed once, I think. But doing any kind of work on a Previa is a nightmare because it's a mid-engine. Everything is stuffed up under there. Because of this, a lot of mechanics don't like to work on these vans, and they'll charge you a fortune. But fortunately, the good thing is, not many things go wrong with these vans. Like I said, it's a more than 20-year-old van, it's got more than 200,000 miles, and it still works. It still works, and it works good now. And Toyota sold a ton of these vans, and they weren't cheap, I think. I think they were around 30,000. First came out, a new minivan that cost a lot. It has rear AC back there, see? Pretty cool. Toyota definitely designed, you know, a very unique minivan, and they engineered it. They over-engineered this van, and that's why so many of them are still on the road today, you know? Yeah, so it's a great van. Toyota sold a lot of these, so I mean, you'll find a lot of them in the junkyard now, so you can like get parts for these pretty easily. Do one little walk around.